spacer will just stop the bearings from binding when you tighten it up. That's a complete roller.
Thank you.
Cut a little slot there, and that's gonna keep the bolt captive once I knock these roll pins in. Cost me a bit of massaging off camera to get the roll pins in, but they're in, and there's absolutely no slop on the bolt. As you can see, I've made the locating hole here, so the bolt is going to thread right through the wall of the roller and into the handle, and the handle is pretty snug, no excess slop or anything, so I'm pretty happy with it, and the nail also came out pretty nice. And what I've done is I've just taken the edge off the nail with sandpaper. This bolt has got an issue, need to replace it. Okay, and the handle's got no play on it. Now for a test. Some of the features that I've included is a knoll on the top roller to give it extra grip. And I've also added V-grooves for round stock, so that the round stock will track straight into the roller. Because on my previous design, the round stock went all over the place. It was quite a mission to get it to sit still. You have to manually keep it in place. But at least now you don't need to. Well, it survived my testing. I'm pretty pleased with it. This will be my father's birthday present on the 13th, because he's been using my vice mounted ring roller about 20 times more than I do. So I've decided to make him his own dedicated one that he can bolt to a bench, or clamp it, so whichever method he prefers. And yeah, hopefully he's happy with it. It will do what he, all the functions that he needs it to do. He usually works with the rod up to 6 millimeters. I've tested it on 8 and it's working pretty well. And flat bar, it also bends flat bar pretty well and very easily. So yeah, I hope you enjoy this build. It's a quite a complex build, and it may look simple from the outside, but there's a lot of small little parts that you need to make this thing work, and things that you have to take in consideration. Until next time, cheers.